हेलो एवरीवन, आई होप यू ऑल आर हेल्दी एंड फाइन एंड यूटिलाइजिंग योर टाइम इन सम कंस्ट्रक्टिव एक्टिविटीज। सिंस वी नो ड्यू टू दिस कोविड पेंडेमिक द ऑनलाइन क्लासेस विल कंटिन्यू फॉर मोर टाइम, सो वी हैव ट्राइड टू मेक द टीचिंग मोर इंटरेस्टिंग इन एंड वी हैव मेड वीडियोज, पॉडकास्ट एटसेट्रा। सो हेयर इज अ वीडियो ऑन केमिकल प्रॉपर्टीज ऑफ मेटल्स एंड नॉन मेटल्स। सो लेट अस सी What is there in this? First chemical property that we are going to study is reaction with oxygen. When metals react with oxygen, they form metal oxides, which are basic in nature. Some metals react vigorously with oxygen, some moderately with oxygen, and some slowly with oxygen. And there are some set of metals which do not react with oxygen at all. So, the reaction with different components, different substances, depend upon reactivity of metals. Okay, so there is a reactivity series, as you can see in this slide. Potassium, sodium, calcium, magnesium, aluminium, zinc, iron, lead, hydrogen, copper, mercury, silver, gold. As we go down the series, reactivity of metals decreases. So when potassium reacts with oxygen, it reacts vigorously with oxygen. Sodium reacts vigorously with oxygen. The reaction is explosive in nature, and the reaction can take place at even at room temperature. So sodium and potassium, when they come in contact with oxygen at room temperature, they burn and produce sodium and potassium oxides respectively. Reaction of calcium with oxygen is also vigorous, but not as vigorous as sodium and potassium. This reaction is also exothermic in nature. Now let us come to magnesium. When magnesium is burnt, it produces white dazzling flame, and the reaction is quite slow as compared to calcium, sodium and potassium. Means in magnesium you have to ignite it. You have to provide ignition temperature to it. But sodium and potassium, they react on their own at even at room temperature. Next, let us come to the next set of elements: aluminium, zinc, iron, copper, mercury. When they are burnt, when they are kept on flame, they do not burn. They produce layer of their oxides on them. They react with oxygen, but they just produce a layer of oxides above them. Aluminium oxide, zinc oxide, iron oxide, copper oxide, and mercury oxide. Okay, so as you can see in this, as we go down the series, reactivity decreases. Metals which are above the reactivity series, they burn explosively. Metals which are below the reactivity series, they do not burn. They just form a layer of their oxides on them. Next is reaction of metals with water. When metals react with water, they form metal hydroxide and hydrogen gas is evolved. Again, the reactivity depends upon metals, is different from differ from metals to metals. Potassium, sodium, they react violently with water. The hydrogen evolved immediately catches flame because the reaction is highly exothermic. Calcium reacts readily with water. The reaction is fast. Calcium with water form calcium hydroxide and hydrogen gas. The hydrogen gas evolved in this case surrounds calcium metal, due to which it floats when it is reacting with water. Next comes magnesium. Magnesium reacts very slowly with cold water, but it reacts with hot water. So if you heat up the mixture of magnesium and water, reactions speed up. Next is these metals, zinc, iron, aluminium. These metals do not react with liquid form of water. They react with steam, which are highly energetic particles. Okay, so they can react with steam to form their oxides. As we go down, copper, silver, lead, they do not react with water at all. So again, you can see, as we go down the group, down the reactivity series, the reactivity of metals decreases. right? This is all about reaction with water. Let us come to our next slide. Next is reaction of metals with acids. When metals react with acid, they evolve hydrogen gas and salt is formed, metal salt is formed. This thing you have studied in chapter 1 also. Hydrogen gas is evolved. This gas is tested by bringing a burning matchstick near it. The matchstick burns with pop sound. This is a confirmatory test for hydrogen gas. So metals when react with hydrochloric acid, they form metal chloride. Metals when react with sulfuric acid, they form metal sulfate. Metals when react with nitric acid, they form metal nitrate. Let us see some examples of reactivity of metal with hydrochloric acid. These are the few examples. You can see with sodium and potassium, K and Na, again the reaction is highly explosive. With calcium, the reaction is violent. With magnesium, the reaction is rapid. And with zinc, it is moderate. So as you can see, when we go down, they react, but the reaction speed of the reaction keeps on decreasing. Or you can say the rate of the reaction keeps on decreasing, right? So here you can see iron. Iron with hydrochloric acid, the reaction is slow to produce iron chloride and hydrogen gas. So hydrogen is evolved in all the cases. Now see the reactivity series. Here copper, mercury, silver and gold. They are below hydrogen in the reactivity series. They will not displace hydrogen from acid. They will not undergo single displacement reaction with dilute acids. Okay, so they are unreactive. So this kind of reaction is a single displacement reaction. See the first equation, potassium. Potassium is above hydrogen. See the reactivity series. Potassium is above hydrogen. Potassium is more reactive than hydrogen. So potassium displaces hydrogen from acid to form potassium chloride and hydrogen gas. So this is a kind of single displacement reaction. The metals which are more reactive than hydrogen displace hydrogen from dilute acid. Is reaction of metals with solution of other metal salts. The example given here is of iron plus copper sulfate to form iron sulfate and copper. This is again known as single displacement reaction, in which a more reactive element displaces less reactive element. See the first equation. Magnesium plus copper sulfate forms magnesium sulfate plus copper. Magnesium, see the position of magnesium in the reactivity series. Magnesium lies above copper. So magnesium is more reactive than copper. Thus magnesium displaces copper from copper sulfate to form magnesium sulfate and copper. Color changes that you are observing in this, going to observe in this case. Copper sulfate is blue in color. Magnesium sulfate is transparent in color. So the color changes from blue to transparent. And brown deposits of copper are seen. Next is zinc plus copper sulfate to form zinc sulfate and copper. Zinc sulfate is transparent, copper is brown. So you will see again the color of the solution changes from blue to transparent and brown deposits. Iron plus copper sulfate to form iron sulfate and copper. Again you see the position of iron, it is above copper. It displaces copper to form iron sulfate and copper. Color of iron sulfate is green. See the second figure. In second figure, you see when iron nail is dipped in copper sulfate solution, the color of the solution turns pale green and brown deposits of copper are formed. So this is about displacement reactions. Okay, so metal which is above in the reactivity series displaces the metal which is below in the reactivity series. So let us do some exercises. This is for you to do. Test your understanding. Reactivity series is given to you. Now check whether these reactions are possible or not. Pb plus FeSO4. See the position of Pb and see the position of Fe. Pb is below Fe. Thus Pb is less reactive than Fe. Pb will not displace Fe from FeSO4. Hence, the first reaction is not possible. no change will take place. Now let us come to the second one. I think you can easily guess whether second reaction is possible or not. Yes, it is possible. Iron is more reactive than lead. It displaces lead from lead chloride to form iron chloride and lead metal. Third, fourth, and fifth. Let us check whether these reactions are possible or not. Calcium is more reactive than magnesium, so it displaces magnesium from magnesium chloride, right? See the position of silver and zinc. Silver is below zinc. So silver is less reactive than zinc. Silver will not displace zinc from zinc sulfate. Similarly, you see the last equation, sodium, Na. Na is more reactive than aluminium. Check their positions once again. So Na will displace aluminium from aluminium sulfate to form sodium sulfate and aluminium metal. So I hope you have understood the displacement reaction now. The definition is a more reactive metal displaces a less reactive metal from its salt solution. Next, this is the last slide, comparison of reactivity of metals and non-metals, that is chemical properties of metals and non-metals. Metals have tendency to donate electrons. Non-metals have tendency to receive electrons. Non-metals have more than 4 electrons in outermost shell. Therefore, they can gain electrons. Metals have less than 4 in outermost shell. Therefore, they can lose electrons. Next is, metals displace hydrogen from dilute acids. Non-metals do not displace hydrogen from dilute acids. Metals react with oxygen to form metal oxides, which are basic in nature. Non-metals react with oxygen to produce non-metal oxides, which are acidic in nature. Right? So we have understood that metal oxides are basic in nature, so they can react with acids. And non-metal oxides are acidic in nature, they can react with base. But there are some set of metal oxides which are both the properties, that is both acidic and basic behavior they show. Those are known as amphoteric oxides. Example, aluminium oxide and zinc oxide. Zinc oxide, when reacts with hydrochloric acid, will act as base to form zinc chloride and water. Zinc oxide, when react with sodium hydroxide, here it will act as acid to form sodium zincate and water. So there are some sets of metal oxides which are amphoteric. Amphoteric means they show both acidic and basic behavior. I hope the topic is clear to you. Thank you very much.